Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime 92, and today I'll be looking at the SD Gundam World Xiahou Yuan Tallgeese. I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. The link is in the description below. So, I've already reviewed the Tallgeese 3, and this one is the majority of the same parts. It's different face, mask, mohawk, shoulder armor, and I believe that's pretty much it. It just got slightly recolored, because Tallgeese 3 is mostly white as well. And I have to say, I like this much more because of the face mask. You actually get a sticker for the visor, it's not clear. Which is very nice. Because if you take this off, you do have the normal Gundam eyes with the sticker. But we all know that the Tallgeese had a visor. And it just looks a lot better when it's not clear plastic with, like, the ability to see the eyes underneath. Now, they put a lot of stickers on the mohawk, which I think it would have been perfectly fine just being clear orange. I don't know why they did that. It just makes it look, I think, kind of messy. You have metallic orange stickers on the new shoulder armor. And they don't have to put any stickers on the chest like they did with the Tallgeese 3. And then you have the white ones on the feet, just like the Tallgeese 3. So I think in the look department, they definitely did a better job with this one. Although I might have to glue the mohawk on. But the head is ball jointed. It can hinge back quite a bit. The arms are ball jointed with the torso joint to go forward. Ball jointed at the shoulder, at the wrist, at the double joint at the stomach, which is a little hindered because of the molding in the stomach armor. It's not too bad. Ball jointed waist. We got the ball jointed thigh armor, although it doesn't really move because you still have the new thighs, which bulk it up, which also greatly hinder the actual articulation in the thighs. And you do have the knee joint and the ball jointed ankle. So, just like the Tallgeese 3, it is hindered in the lower legs just because they wanted to give you the bulkier thighs, which I like personally. So, you gotta take something and lose something. Now, accessory wise, you have the shield, which looks pretty cool. No stickers on that, and I don't think it needs it. Just like I don't think the mohawk does. And it just goes on a ball joint there. And then we have the gun, which comes with the same wing memory. Just the same accessories here, just that the colors are different. And it just plugs into there, and then you can plug it onto the other shoulder. Like that. I don't know why that keeps happening. Guess I need to stop grabbing it from the mohawk. But that's it for the Tallgeese. Now, that's it for the Tallgeese model. But if you bring in your Tallgeese 3 and you bring in the Wing Zero, you can take the new armor here, or the new weapons, and do a few things. Now, with the Tallgeese in the comic, in the manual, you're supposed to take the guns and give them to the Tallgeese 1. And now it kind of looks like the, what's it called? The Deep Arms from Seed. Which is kind of cool. I like that. And you're supposed to give the shields to the Tallgeese 3. Which I like less. Although, if you take both of the guns, oops. But you do have to open them up. So they each have a hinge. Take out the memory. So you can open them here, and then you can take the cannon barrel, and it's supposed to still be in the ball joint. It just goes at the back, so it's facing in the same direction as the clear piece. So you do that with both, taking out the memory. Now, if you do this too many times, I can see the clear breaking, because it is clear, and you're moving it on a hinge. So you just want to make sure that the barrel's on the opposite sides. And then you take the wing gundam, and you insert the wing memories into the backpack. Preferably the right way, just with the indent piece facing inward. Like so. And then you can take the cannons. Once again, make sure the barrels are facing out. You got a hole on the foot, you got a tab right there. And we also have these, where are they? These little clear teeth, which kind of go on either side of this bar in the foot. And now, the Wing Gundam has snowshoes. At least that's why I call them, because they're really weird looking. But yeah, this is a power up for the Wing Gundam, which is way less impressive than the power up using the Barbatos with the unicorn. Because they don't really look like anything, where the other ones, they don't definitely look like feet. These look like rollerblades or something. So, not a big fan. And it does also make him stand weird. He has to, like, lean forward. Like, arch the back. So, it's definitely a weird idea. I mean, it's nice that, I guess, it can interact with the other models. But this also leaves your Tallgeese, both of them, with no weapon. They just have a shield, so it might not have been so bad if they had also got a beam saber or something. But I don't like having my models with, like, nothing, so I'm definitely not gonna display like that. But that is the Messy World Tallgeese. I like it. I like it more than the Tallgeese 3, once again, because the face mask is solid. And I do like the Tallgeese original in general. But I'm not a big fan of all these stickers on the Mohawk. I might take those off. But if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.